For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Venezuela's new National Assembly was officially sworn in on January 5th. The investiture of the new legislative body marks the end of submission to U.S. imperialism and the return of the legacy of revolutionary leaders Liberator Simón Bolívar and Commander Hugo Chávez. The Great Patriotic Poll, led by the ruling United Socialist Party of Venezuela, PSUV, and other Chavista forces, hold a majority in the new National Assembly, elected for the period 2021 to 2026. The PSUV Alliance won a resounding victory in the parliamentary elections held on December 6, 2020, and secured 257 of the 277 seats in the country's unicameral parliament. The swearing-in ceremony began at 11 a.m. and was held at the headquarters of the National Assembly in the capital Caracas, with all of the sanitary measures in place against COVID-19. Presidents and heads of state from across the world joined the ceremony. Representatives of various social organizations from across Latin America were also present at the event. Meanwhile, the European Union has withdrawn the support that they had been extending for the self-proclaimed opposition leader, Juan Guaido. Ahead of the ceremony, paintings of Bolívar and Chávez were returned to the parliament's hemicycle. They were removed following the victory of the right-wing forces in the 2015 elections. With the inauguration of the new Congress, the people of Venezuela will recover its parliament and legislative independence.
Se los digo sin ánimo retórico, no podemos fracasar. Esta vez no podemos sino triunfar. Esta vez tenemos que reparar lo dañado. Tenemos que reconstruir lo destruido. Tenemos que recomponer lo que fue deteriorado por la traición, por el odio y por la violencia.
For the past 5 years, under the dominance of the right-wing parties, the legislative body was used as a tool in attempts to overthrow the democratically elected government of Socialist President Nicolás Maduro. The new National Assembly faces a number of challenges, such as the restoration of economic, institutional, political, and social stability in the country. It has a great responsibility of drafting and enacting laws that can confront the great economic crisis generated by the numeral unilateral coercive measures imposed by the United States on Venezuela. President Nicolás Maduro, in a meeting on January 4th, asked the newly elected deputies of PSUV coalition to focus on promoting the political dialogue, reconciliation, coexistence, and inclusion in the country's economy.